Hi everyone, Adrian Violi from AuthenticDrummer.com. Thanks very much for watching. This is an instructional video on how to set up a Perl export drum kit. I've been invited by Perl to show you this. If you're a beginner or an intermediate, this is your first kit or your second kit, there should be something for everybody in this video. We're gonna go right from the beginning, setting it up from unpacking it out of the boxes, tuning, getting angles right, looking at some of the features of the kit, all the way up to having it play. So I'm going to take you from this to this. Let's get started.
The export series we're setting up today is called a Fusion Plus kit. It features 10 and 12 inch rack toms, a 16 inch floor tom, a 14 inch snare drum, and a 22 inch bass drum. Perl also offer two other configurations featuring larger rack toms or a smaller floor tom. Regardless of the configuration you have, the setup advice in this video is the same. We'll be setting up for a right-handed drummer today, but you would need to reverse the positioning of the drums and cymbals if you are a left-handed drummer. Your export series comes in three boxes, and you will need to put most of it together yourself. However, the floor tom, rack toms, and snare drum are already assembled for you. Remove all plastic from the drums themselves and set aside the bass drum hoops. You'll also need to remove all the hardware from their paper wrappings as well. Just be careful not to lose anything that might be loose. Take note and be careful not to lose any of the small fittings with the drum kit, including the bass drum hooks and particularly your drum key. You're going to need this. Unpack all your hardware and have it ready to go, including floor tom legs, pedal, hi-hat stand, snare stand, two cymbal stands, and two tom arms. We're now going to put our bass drum heads on. Place your bass drum so the tom holder is closer to the top and the bass drum legs facing down. Take the black bass drum head with the Perl logo and place over the shell. Try and line the Perl logo up with the tom holder as best you can. Then place a hoop without the black hoop protector flat side down over the head. Take a bass drum hook and tension rod, place over the hoop and feed into the lug on the bass drum. Just use your fingers to tighten at this stage. You'll need to repeat this process with the other lugs on the drum. When you have all hooks onto the bass drum, just go around and finger tighten them all. This is a prequel to actually tuning the drum, and it tries to get everything as even as possible. Using your hand, apply pressure to the head until you see wrinkles, then take your drum key and apply half a turn per lug, moving in a crisscross action. This seats the head and provides some tension to which you can fine tune later should you wish. At this stage, you should start to hear a note coming from the bass drum. Turn the bass drum over so we can repeat the process on the other side. Take the clear head and place over the shell with the Perl logo at the top, followed by the bass drum hoop flat side down as before. Note that this time we have the black hoop protector down the bottom. This is where our pedal will attach later on, and it protects the hoop. As we did before, we're going to need to take our bass drum hooks with our tension rods and feed into the lugs. Remember to place it nice and evenly over the hoop and just finger tighten. We also need to do this with the remaining hooks. And it's also worth noting that the hoop protector needs to line up perfectly with the tom holder. Because we haven't tightened the hooks yet, you might need to adjust the hoop ever so slightly, and you should be able to move it. When you think you've got it where you want it, simply finger tight all the tension rods as we did before. Using your drum key and applying pressure in the center of the drum, as we did before, half a turn in a crisscross fashion across each of the lugs, to start to seat the head and apply tension. Try and be as even as you possibly can at this point. let's have a look at the bass drum pedal. Using your drum key, loosen the lug nearest to the cam on the pedal. This is where our beater will go. The beater itself has a plastic or felt playing surface. We're going to use felt today. Feed the beater in about a quarter of a way and tighten into position using your drum key. This can be adjusted later if you want to make the beater higher or lower. At this point, you'll notice that the beater is actually sitting too far forward. Using your drum key, you can adjust this by loosening this lug. Pull the beater back to where you want the beater to start from, and then tighten. Again, this can be adjusted to your liking later on once you've got it on the bass drum. Now take a cymbal stand, loosen the wing nut, and spread the legs out like this to create a base. Retighten and place on the floor. Take the middle pole, loosen the wing nut, and insert like so. This can be height adjusted later on should you wish. Now take the top part of the cymbal stand. This is the one with the head on it. Feed into the tube like so. Again, adjusting where you decide you want it, and tighten the wing nut. The adjustable tilter on the top will be loose. Point at a slight angle and tighten up. This is where our cymbal will go later on. Now it's time for the other cymbal stand. Like before, loosen the wing nut and spread the legs out. Place on the floor. Take the next size tubing and loosen the wing nut, place where you think you want it, and tighten up. Again, can all be adjustable later. The top part of this stand is in two sections. The first part is just like the other cymbal stand, except that it's missing the head. Tighten into place, and then notice how the top can swivel like so, and has a hole which allows for a boom arm. The boom arm is the thin piece of hardware that looks like this. You can feed that through the hole, and you'll notice that at this point you can angle the arm however you want. This is particularly useful for cymbals that need to reach over drums or get into tight places. As we did before, Pearl's infinitely adjustable tilter will allow you to get a precise angle on your cymbal. Another unique feature with this stand is that you can actually turn it into a straight stand by feeding the arm through down into the other tubes. Very handy. Our snare stand is put together much the same way as our cymbal stands. Loosen the wing nut, spread the legs out to create a base. Then take the top part of the stand, loosen the very large wing nut, let the stand fall, and tighten up in a straight position. Now feed that into the other stand like so, and tighten via the wing nut. You'll notice here we have our cradle. This is what our snare is actually going to sit on. You can open the cradle like so, and you can adjust it via the big wing nut by loosening it and then angling the snare drum whichever way you want. You can also use the adjustment wheel to accommodate different size snare drums. Let's move on to the hi-hat stand now. These rods will need to feed into two small holes at the base of the stand to form our pedal. Once fed into the holes, they spring into place and stay there. As you can see now, we have our pedal. Placed on the floor, loosen the wing nut and spread the legs out exactly like you did before with your other stands. You'll also notice by pushing the pedal down, you'll see the rod moving inside the stand. Take the top section of the stand and remove the rod from the tubing. Attach and screw together with the internal rod we mentioned before. Then remove the clutch, apply the tubing over the top and feed into the base of the stand. This can be adjustable later, but for now, tighten at a medium height via the wing nut. We'll apply the cymbals later, so just put your clutch back like this.
Okay, so we've come this far. We've got the drums together, and we've got the hardware together, and we're going to put the kit together now. But before we do that, it's also a really good idea just to check the tuning of your drums before you get it on the kit, because when you've got it on the kit and you strike the drum, you're going to hear the top and bottom heads at the same time. Whereas if you do it this way individually, you can look at each head by themselves before you get it onto the drum kit, and that's actually not a bad way to go. Now, Pearl have been really nice, and because this is a beginner to intermediate kit, it's a slightly step up from the real beginner stuff, they've actually got it already together for you, and some decent quality heads as well. So you're going to find that this is not that hard to get a decent sound out of straight away. In fact, if I put it all together now and just have a whack on it, it's probably going to be pretty good. But let's have a bit of a check anyway. There's a couple of ways you can do a quick tune on a kit. For a drum that's already tensioned already like this, I would push my fingers down into the center of the drum and just check for any major wrinkles. If you've got any real major wrinkles, you can usually take them out of there just by giving you the tuning key and give it a bit of a turn. The idea is to get everything as even as possible. Okay, for the sake of this one, this is already together and feeling really reasonably good. But hypothetically speaking, if it was detuned like so, if I push down to the drum, you'll see a bunch of wrinkles. Okay. The idea is when you get to this point, say if you want to change your head, for instance, if you get to that point, finger tight everything, so at least you know you're starting on the same platform, so everything's about the same. Okay, hence why the Lazy Susan's really good, because you can do a quick turnaround. All right, and now you push in the center of the head, and then using your drum key, just go around and do maybe half a turn for each lug. And the reason I'm pushing into the center of the drum is to kind of seat the head, but also so I can check if there's any wrinkles. And at the moment there's not. Another way you can do it, if you're a little bit more experienced with this stuff, is you can do a little bit of a hit around each of the drums. And when you hear one that's a little bit off, you can tune that one up. So. Okay, so that's the bottom head, and I reckon that's going to be pretty cool. I usually have the bottom head a little bit tighter than the top head, and that gives a very classic sound with a bit of a dip in the sound of the drum. If you want, you can have both heads exactly the same tension, and that'll be a very full, open sound as well. So you can have a bit of a muck around with it. It's something to have a practice of. It takes a little bit of time. You would turn the drum, back over, like so, and you would repeat the process with the top head. So you have a bit of a check. This one can be a little bit looser, yeah, because we can go a little bit lower in the sound if you want. So yeah. All right, so if I now take that off the cushioning and give it a bit of a whack, it should sound pretty cool. All right, so you would repeat the same process with the 12-inch tom. This is the 10, the 12, and then the 16-inch floor tom. And we're gonna have a look at the bass drum right now. Okay, so with the bass drum, as we did before when we put the heads on, and we did a bit of a seat thing where we pushed in the middle of the head and then put the tension rods on, you actually find that the bass drum doesn't sound that bad at the moment. It sounds quite good. The only thing to do at this point really is just to double check, if you want to, check the pitches of each of the tension rods, and then make sure they're nice and even. At the moment, there's nothing inside this bass drum. This is quite, it's empty, and that's gonna give it a very open sound, all right? So a typical bass drum sound that you would hear on a recording would have some sort of dampening in there. So maybe a pillow or a blanket or a sheet, something you can find at home lying around. The idea is something touching the front head and something touching the back head as well. Now, I think about this bass drum and the export series is that Remo make the drum heads for the factory for these drums. And that means that the head that they've chosen to put on here has a dampening ring around the outside, which means that you've got your normal head and then you've got an extra ring on the inside. And that actually helps to take away some of those overtones that are usually unwanted, okay? So having said that though, I'm gonna do a little bit of a pitch check around here and see if we can hear some differences. And I'm just trying to get it as even as possibly can. I was pretty much spot on with before when we put the drum head on. That's the quick way of doing it. So head on, quick push in the middle, get your wrinkles out, half a turn each, and it usually puts in okay. Okay, you can flip the bass drum over and do exactly the same thing on the other side. Okay, so here it's very apparent. You can see the actual extra bit of bass drum head in the middle there, the dampening ring. So that's gonna give this bass drum a fairly deep sound. It's gonna sound quite nice. At this point here, I'm actually liking the way that's sounding just because we've did the initial put the head on right. If you didn't just decided to put the head on, just get the tension rods on there, you would need to do it all finger tight for around the outside and then go through, and if you like, you can tap on each of them and find a pitch that you like and then tighten up. But the thing is with the bass drums, you like to have them a little bit lower than the rest of the drums, all right? So they're supposed to have a low thud kind of sound. All right, so keeping the bass drum head really loose is not a bad thing.
Place your bass drum on its side and loosen the bass drum leg via the wing nut like so. It's a good idea to have your bass drum leg at an angle, so when you play the bass drum from the batter side, it's got something to push against. You can also lengthen the bass drum leg via the second wing nut. At this point, turn your bass drum around and repeat on the other side. At this point also, we want to extend the legs as far as they can go on both sides. You'll notice that your bass drum sits slightly off the floor. This is good because when you put your pedal on the other side, it'll even out. Now we can attach the pedal to the bass drum. Lift the bass drum slightly and slide the hoop between the bass and the clamp of the pedal. Make sure there is clearance between the bass drum head and the pedal itself. Then you can tighten the clamp like this. The beater should strike in the center of the bass drum. Should you need to, you can readjust the height of the beater as we did earlier. As mentioned just now, we adjust the hoop clamp like this. If you do not get a tight fit at this point, Pearl have included two different sized inserts that you can place in between the hoop and the clamp. This will ensure a snug fit every time. It's now time to put the toms onto the bass drum. Loosen the wing nuts on the tom holder, take one of your tom arms, and feed into the bass drum like this. You'll notice that the stop block stops it from going down any further. Tighten the wing nut and repeat on the other side with the other tom arm. You'll also notice that the wing nuts on the tom arms themselves are facing outwards for adjustment later. Take your first rack tom, wing nut facing up, loosen like so, and slide onto the tom arm like this. Retighten the wing nut once in position. Now take your second rack tom and do the same on the other side. At this point, it's worth noting what this stop block does. Loosen to adjust with your drum key, and you'll see that it slides back and forth over the arm like this. To demonstrate, When we put the rack tom on without the stop lock, the arm feeds all the way through the OptiLock mount and can touch the shell. To prevent long-term wear and tear, set your tom without the arm touching the shell and then push the stop lock into place, tightening with your drum key. Once it's set, it's ready for future setups. Stop locks are also used to memorize the height of your tom arms when you put them into the tom holder and are adjustable via the drum key. The tom arm itself can be adjusted for angle using the wing nut, for higher or lower, should you wish. I've kept them reasonably flat at this stage. Here you can also see the OptiLock mounting system, which allows the drum to resonate freely. Now we're ready for the floor tom. Turn the floor tom upside down with the leg mounts closer to the top of the drum like this. Take one leg and partially insert through the mount, leaving the majority of the leg upwards. Tighten the wing nut to secure. You'll need to repeat on the other two mounts. The reason we don't insert them too far is because this is the height of our floor tom. Turn the drum the right way up and place near the drum kit, and then adjust as you see fit to angle the drum towards you. You may need to sit down for this.
Okay, so we've got to this point now where we've got our toms on and our floor tom. It's time to now start thinking about the snare drum. Now, snare drum, like the other drums that came with the Pearl Export, it was already assembled in the box. And they usually keep the tension in the drums nice and low, so for transport, so the shells aren't under any pressure when they're in the transit. Before we put it on the snare stand, I want to give it a quick tune, so I'm going to show you how to do that. First of all, we're going to turn the drum upside down and start with the underside. You can see here we've got our snare wires underneath. This is exactly what gives our snare its sound. On this side, we can see the wires are attached via this locking mechanism there, and another one on this side, except this one here has what we call a throw off, and that means that we can actually loosen the snare strainer completely from the drum if we want. Using that, we can also adjust the tension of that wire using this knob here. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to loosen that off, all right, and we're going to turn the drum upside down with it off, and what I want to do is try and get a stick underneath the snare strainer like so. And the reason why I want to do that is because I want it to be off the drum when I'm trying to tune, okay? So it's not getting in the way of the sound that I'm hearing. So all I can hear at this point is that head, okay? Taking your key, yeah, you can go have a bit of a feel, and if you're pushed down on it, you can see it's quite squishy, all right? What you want to do is bring it up a little bit. So just taking your key and going in opposite directions to try and get as even as possible. Just, we're going to start with half a turn on each one. It's starting to happen now. We want a fairly tight bottom head. Okay, I'm going to go a little bit tighter. You can even just go around in a circle if it helps, but that's pretty cool. All right, what I'm doing there is I'm actually having a bit of a listen to the sound or the pitch that's coming from those lugs, and I'm trying to get them all to be exactly the same. Now, if you've never done this before, sometimes just using your feel, the tension, like we were doing before, going around with the key, as long as you do it all even, it'll be pretty much spot on. But if you want to get into the nitty gritty of tuning, that's when we get into the listening to each lug individually and trying to match the pitch. So if one sounds a bit lower, you would need to bring it up to match the other one. It's a bit of a fine art. Now we're going to look at the top head, and we're going to repeat the process that we did on the bottom head by going around and tuning up half a turn per lug to try and get it as even as we possibly can. Okay. Okay, so that's feeling pretty cool at the moment. I might go just a fraction higher just to be fun. We have a snare. Let's put it on the kit.
To begin with, we need to open the cradle like this. When you place your drum onto the cradle, you need to make sure that it is wide enough to accommodate the shell itself. It needs to go over the hoops. Keep your snare straighter on the left-hand side so you can always get to it quickly. Then using the adjustment ring, turn anti-clockwise to tighten the cradle onto the drum. At this point, you can also adjust via the large wing nut to angle the drum should you wish. You can also adjust the height of the snare stand like this. Now let's put the ride cymbal on the stand. Remove the nut like this, followed by one felt. You'll notice the bottom washer extends through the remaining felt to create a protective sleeve for the cymbal. Carefully line up the cymbal and place on the stand like this. Place the felt, followed by the nut. This nut is actually reversible as well. By turning it on the other side, you can have a tighter fit. It is important not to have it too tight at this point. Allow the cymbal to move. We need to repeat the process with our crash cymbal. Remove the nut. Followed by one felt. Line the cymbal up as before, place on the stand, replace the felt, and then the nut. The crash cymbal gets hit quite hard, so don't tighten too much. If you do, just loosen up a bit. Now we're going to put our hi-hats on. This is the clutch. It attaches to the rod like this. When you push the pedal, you'll see that the cymbals that will be cradled between it will move up and down. To operate it, remove the nut and one of the felts. We're going to place our top hi-hat in there. Before that though, take the heavier of the two cymbals that you have, or the one that says bottom hi-hat, place upside down over the rod. Then, take your clutch, feed through the cymbal like this, then replace the felt, and then the nut. Tighten up so it's reasonably firm, but not too firm. Again, this cymbal needs to move as well. Then carefully place over the rod and slide down. At this point, you can tighten with a gap in between, and then use your pedal to hear what it sounds like. Now we're ready to assemble the kit fully. Place your hi-hat to the left of the snare drum like this. Place your crash cymbal in between the hi-hat and the first rack tom, adjusting the height as you need to. Finally, place your ride cymbal on the boom stand just over the floor tom like this, and use the tilter or the arm to angle towards you like this. Again, you may need to sit down for this and do it from there. there we have our drum kit.
Okay, so there you have it. Pearl Export, from nothing in the box to set up complete in front of you. I hope you got something out of this video. And you know, good luck with your export in the future. It's a great kit for the money. Some things to think about in the future is how to make your kit more you. You know, drum kits are very personal, and that's why they're all very different, because everyone has a different taste and different sound in their head. For example, cymbals, you know, today we're using the Zildjian CHT, and they're a great intermediate cymbal if you're in the market, and you have to be if you're buying a kit like this, you know, upgrade your cymbals. Skins, they are the first thing usually to wear out on a drum kit. These heads on here are factory heads from Remo, which is great that Pearl actually offer their export with Remo heads. But you may find that you want thicker heads or thinner heads, you know, so your choice. So you'll change your mind, but that's all part of the fun of being a drummer, because personal sound is personal sound. Experiment with the angles on your drum kit too. You might like your toms a little bit higher and a little bit more angled towards you. Same thing for your snare. The 830 series hardware here allows for some pretty precise adjustments for your setup, so you'll have to experiment with that too. Also, with the Demonator pedal that comes with this kit, I don't really know if there's another kit on the market that offers a pedal as good as this for this money with this kit, or with a kit like this. So experiment with that pedal, getting your setup right, spring tension, locking the spring, you know, angle of the beater, all that sort of stuff. It's a great pedal, and I reckon you'll get some great use out of it. So yeah, get into it, have some fun, check out some lessons, and enjoy your brand new Pearl Export.